How do you guys and gals? Another vid on Kawasaki. Done a few things since I last put a vid up. First one was I fitted a set of little mini indicators. These are some cheaper eBay ones. I've put these on while I get a set of Kozo. But I just couldn't stand them big stalkers anymore. So they look so much better. The Kozo ones are very similar to them, but they're metal. Bodied, a bit better quality. I will say, if you put your mini indicators on, you definitely want to get these connectors. These are the bullet connectors from your standard indicators to the Kawasaki connector. See if I can just focus it on. There you go. So most aftermarket indicators will come with bullet connectors on, but your Kawasaki have got them on the end, so you don't want to chop the wire. So you want a set of them for each indicator, and they're only a couple of quid odd from eBay. Shout up below and I'll give you a link if anybody wants to know where to get them from. You'll also need a resistor on, or else it'll blink too fast. You're only again, I got mine from R&G, which are a bit more expensive, but there's a good chance them resistors won't overheat. Well, there you go. Good enough at the moment till my Kozo's come. So that was that's my first mod. My second, and I went over to Leeds yesterday, over that fucking saddle moor or something, M60, M62, and what a fucking shit motorway that is. 50 mile an hour all the way, but over Saddle Moor, nice, but fucking freezing. Anyway, I digress. I went to a place called Jordan's in Leeds to get the ECU flashed, which I did eventually. Had a bit of a fucking argument with them up there. My fault in a way. I had the tyre plugged when I got a puncture. And of course, being so fucking health and safety correct, the fuckers wouldn't put it on the dyno, so I was going to lose 100 quid deposit. Well, 100 quid and get fucking locked away for bastard arguing with them. Fucking hell, 100 quid. Anyway, I bought a tyre. So I had to put a new tyre on before I could get it on the dyno. Good in a way, I suppose. I mean, peace of mind for riding with a plug-in, especially with a bike that's now putting out this horsepower. But I've got to scrub the bastard in again. I've just been out now and it's been raining on me. So I've stuck this on and I've also put the profile from 50 to 55. And I do find that she does roll into corners better with that. Obviously, I haven't pushed it too far yet because it's got to be scrubbed in. I was only on yesterday, but it does seem to drop a bit quicker into corners. So, I've had the tyre done. Dyno. She pumped out a tad over 150 odd brake. 150, I think it's 151 brake horse now at the crank, which is up about 8 to 9 horses now, and I think it was another 2 or 3 pounds on the torque curve as well. But the big benefit now is it's a nice graph. There's no holes before, because bear in mind I've had the arrow headers on and the cans and the K&M filter, and it left two fucking huge holes around about 5, 6, 7 thousand. They've completely gone now. She pulls wheelies first and second, lovely. And she sounds sweet as fuck without them decibel killers in. I think these fuckers are going to be staying in the drawer now. Well, for a while anyway, until Mrs. breaks me fucking balls over it. So, yep, lovely. Nice to have 150 horses at the crank. And we've only got 2,000 miles on the clock. This motor's got to loosen up a bit yet to 5,000 mile before it's putting out its peak power, so we could probably see a bit of a gain there yet again. And that's just with an ECU flash, so that motor is sweet as a nut now. My third little mod are these lovely little babies. Now, they're not your usual Chinese crap. These are a real quality item, billet alloy, stainless fittings, no play, and the ratchet is on a stainless bearing ratchet. You twat. Ratchet. a stainless ratchet. And these are a quality item. Hard anodized finish. Now, if you want to know where to get them from, drop us a line at the bottom and I'll tell you where you can get them from for around about 50 quid. And to me, 50 quid for a set of quality levers like that. I mean, they look so much and they feel better. Two-fingered levers. Yeah, brilliant. So if anybody wants to know, I'll be quite happy to impart the information. There you go, a good look at them. They feel real nice when you're on the bike. You know, you're two or three fingered, whatever suits you really. I never do more than one or two finger braking. So that's the third little mod I've done. I'm fucking really happy with her now. New tyre, 150 horses, ready for this biking season. And just as a little note, that fucking screen, first time I've been out on the motorway with a screen on. It's brilliant. The difference it's made, keeping that wind off you, just that little screen, top job. So anyway, that's where I am at the moment. I'm loving it, loving the riding. This first time I've been all year on the road, cracking motor. And she's looking how I want to, more or less now, and putting the power out, and she sounds, fuck, does she sound nice. Let's crack her up. Let's annoy every fucker. The phone doesn't do these pipes justice, to be honest with you. The crackle on Overrun is absolutely fantastic. There we go, anyway. Anybody's out Sunday tomorrow around Stoke on the Easter Egg Run, if it's going to be dry, I shall be there. Mate will probably be there on his triple. If you see the bike, come say hello. Okay, you lot have a good weekend and I'll catch you on the next video.